Would you like to learn about some of the presentations that are performed by cloud architects, solutions architects, and enterprise architects? Would you like to know why presentation skills are one of your most critical skills for the cloud architect job or enterprise architect job or even the solutions architect job? If so, this video is for you. Hi, my name is Mike Gibbs, and I'm the founder and CEO of GoCloud Careers, and I've been every kind of IT architect you could think of for the last 25 years. Network architect, enterprise architect, security architect, business architect, cloud architect, and I love these roles. In fact, I actually think they're some of the best roles in the entire technology community. And when people want to become a cloud architect or an enterprise architect, they have to understand they need to learn good presentation skills because we're going to spend about 20% of our time delivering presentations. So what kind of presentations do we deliver as architects? Well, one of the common types of presentations that we'll do as a cloud architect or as an enterprise architect or a solutions architect is what's called an architecture vision presentation. And what's that really about? It's about where do we see that company moving forward? How is the company going to operate, including its people, its processes, and its technologies? And that's typically an architecture vision presentation. We will be delivering a lot of presentations to both internal and external stakeholders on the current state of the architecture. So what does the current technology platform look like? How does that business operate today? So that's the current state. Because when there's a new architecture project, we're going to try to create a new state or a future state. So that's the next type of presentation we deliver is a future state architecture proposal or presentation. And what's that? That's after we've led our design team and we've created an architecture that we think is going to work. We're going to present it back to the client and their key stakeholders and get their feedback. So the next type of presentation we do is what you would consider to be maybe a technology roadmap. And what's going on here is we're looking at the current technology they have and the steps necessary to get them to their long-term goals. So it might be that we need to do something now, maybe have a transition architecture and then have a future state architecture. And all the technologies we'll be adopting along the way, along with the changes to the business processes and the et cetera. So a lot of what we'll do is be called a gap analysis reporting. So what is that? So if we've got a new security architecture and there's an old security architecture, what's the difference between what we have and what we need? What do we need to achieve? That's the gap analysis. It could be, okay, we're in a private cloud and we want to continue to go to the private cloud, but we need something new. What's the difference between what we have and what we know? Could also be a public cloud, a multi-cloud, a hybrid multi-cloud, and in most cases, it will be multi-cloud. We'll be doing a lot of business capability modeling presentations. So what is that? So if we're going to look at a business and we're going to evaluate what kind of technology platforms can help that business, we need to know that business. What is that business's strengths? What is that business's capabilities? What is its weaknesses? What are the threats against it? That kind of thing. So we want to look at that and see what they're good at and understand that business architecture. Now, we'll also be getting involved in the applications. Most global enterprises have between 200 and 1,000 applications, so we're going to have to look at the application portfolio and try to come up with a rational plan around it, and then we're going to present that. We may have an IT governance framework, for example, that we've created for that organization. Now, let's say there's a change that needs to occur, who needs to approve it, that kind of thing. We will be looking at enterprise data models, especially in the world of AI and generative AI. You know, what kind of data do they have now? What's the quality of that data? What do they need to do with that data? And how do they need to use that data, or how could they use that data? We'll be giving a lot of cloud migration strategy presentations. I can tell you that. That's part of the cloud architect job, enterprise architect job all the time. If we're going to the cloud, what do we migrate to the cloud? How many clouds do we use? What's the plan? That kind of thing. A lot of what we do is going to be digital transformation initiatives and presentations about that. So what does that mean? So the business operates this way today. How can we change the way that business operates in the future? And how will technology support that? We're going to do a lot of business capability mapping and look at that organization, its people, processes, and technology. And we're going to actually have to give presentations on, is the strategy working? Is the technology working? And if not, what do we need to do? Align these initiatives. We may do what's called an architecture maturity evaluation, where we look at the business and its current use of technology and how that business operates and its business processes and present that back, because we need the baseline to make changes. We may actually create some presentations on integration strategies of how do we integrate multiple clouds and data centers, how do we integrate the applications in a business. We're constantly going to be involved in risk management reports. So what are the risks on that business? What is the quantitative and qualitative risks of that business? And how do we mitigate them? Do we transfer the risk to, say, an insurance company? Do we mitigate it with security things? We're typically involved in some performance metrics and key performance indicators and maybe some creation of dashboards. Okay, here's the problem. Here's what we did to the problem. What was the impact on the business? Now, we will also do a lot of sales presentations, especially if we're a solutions architect or we're working in a consulting company or, let's say, a cloud provider. We're going to be trying to create an architecture and sell it to our clients along with the account team. We will be involved in what's called executive briefings, especially if we're a solutions architect or we're working on that pre-sales side, where basically you will present to an organization's key executives, maybe the CEO, CFO, CIO, CTO, and some other key executives for an entire day. And you'll, along with other architects and other business leaders from your organization, you'll be giving constant presentations at industry conferences. And guess what? The last phase of a cloud architect interview, enterprise architect interview, solutions architect interview is usually a presentation. So we spend a lot of our time delivering presentations, and presentation skills are one of the most critical skills for cloud architects. So now you have a better understanding of some of the elements of that cloud architect job description. Because I always like to say architecture is design it, present it, and sell it back to the customer. And, you know, there's a lot of things that actually go into that. But these are the types of presentations that cloud architects do, solutions architects do, enterprise architects. So if you want an architecture career, learn to present. It's the secret between getting hired and not getting hired, getting promoted and not getting promoted. Now, if you're looking for your first cloud architect job or solutions architect job or an enterprise architect job or AI architect job, we have free ebooks and free webinars in the description of this video that will help you in your technology career. Come join a free webinar. It'll be on Zoom. We can have a face-to-face conversation and we'll answer any questions you may have about the career. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like, subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your technology career, specifically your cloud architect career, enterprise architect career, AI architect career, or security architect career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care. Thank you.